Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Hello everyone, we are from the fifth group and we are going to explain and answer the IELTS number 27 until 13 and 38 until 14. But first, let me introduce my group.
My name is Alvina Anjahra.
My name is Bagus Adriansyah.
And my name is Emrif Gaditya. And so, let us begin.
Now listen and answer questions 27 to 30.
We thought we'd use three criteria: how attractive each website is, how user-friendly it is, and how closely it targets its potential customers. Do you think that's okay?
Sounds fine, but I'd look at the criteria in a different order if I were you. Because really, you've got to look at attractiveness and user-friendliness in relation to the people the website is aiming at. So I'd deal with that criterion first if I were you.
Right.
What about the timing? Have you thought of that? 10 minutes is very short, you know.
Yes, we tried it out.
Several times.
And we've decided to spend 4 minutes comparing the two sites, then 3 minutes evaluating them, and leave 3 minutes for questions. That's not really enough, but...
Well, it sounds about right to me. You've got 10 minutes altogether, and you've got to stick to that limit. It's good practice. And at least the audience won't have time to get bored. What visuals are you going to use?
We're going to use PowerPoint and a flip chart as well.
So we can show two things at once. For example, we're going to start by showing the home pages of each website, and we're going to put up a list of key features on the flip chart at the same time.
OK, and it's a joint presentation, so have you decided how you're going to share the work?
Yes. First, we thought we'd keep taking it in turns to speak. Sarah would say a bit, then I'd take over, and so on. Then we thought we'd just divide it into two equal parts and do one part each. But it was all too complicated. So Sarah's going to do all the talking, and I'm going to manage the visuals, and hope we can coordinate properly.
It's the only way we can fit everything in.
Well, good. You've obviously worked hard and you've been very careful with the details. Only one thing I would say. Make sure that you keep your visuals simple. I mean, if you're showing a list of key features, for example, you should make it as brief as possible. Just use bullet points and simple phrases, even single words. Your audience won't have much reading time. It's a classic mistake with seminar presentations to present so much information that the audience can't process it quickly enough, and they stop listening to what you're saying. OK?
Yes. Right, OK.
And now let's talk about...
Number 27, because the speaker says there are three basic criteria: how attractive, how friendly it is, and how closely to target customer. So in the number 27, we got target customers in C. So number 27, the answer is C. And next, number 28. In this time, the speaker realized that 10 minutes is very short and not enough, but they don't want to spend more time and make the audience get bored. So the number 28, the answer is B. The student's presentation will be too long.
Number 29, we can hear that Sarah is going to do all the talking and Jack will be managing this work. So we can conclude that they are managing different aspects. So the answer is C. Number 30, we can hear that the tutors advise to stop showing homepage of each website and start to show off list of the key features. So the answer is B, show complicated list.
But what do the sounds mean? Scientists from Pittsburgh Zoo in the USA have classified certain infrasonic calls based on when these occur and how other elephants react to them. They found, for example, that when individual family members reunite after separation, they greet each other very enthusiastically, and the excitement increases with the length of time that they've been separated. They trumpet and scream and touch each other. they also use a greeting rumble. This starts at a low 18 hertz. Hertz is a measurement of sound pitch. Crests at 25 hertz, which is a level just high enough to be audible to humans, and then falls back to 18 hertz again. In another example, an elephant attempting to locate its family uses the contact call. This call has a relatively quiet, low tone with a strong overtone which is clearly audible to humans. Immediately after contact calling, the elephant will lift and spread its ears and rotate its head as if listening for the response. The contact answer is louder and more abrupt than the greeting call, and it trails off at the end. Contact calls and answers can last for hours until the elephant successfully rejoins her family. A third type of call seems to represent a summons to move on. At the end of a meal, one member of a family moves to the edge of the group, typically lifts one leg and flaps her ears. At the same time, she emits a "let's go" rumble, which arouses the family and they start to move on. Finally, mating activity is associated with yet another group of calls. So, our understanding of elephant communication has increased considerably in recent years. However, even with the use of radio tracking collars, it's technically difficult to document the functions of long-range communication. So, although scientists are aware that elephants may know the whereabouts and possibly the activities of other elephants that are several miles away, there may be a lot of subtle long-range interactions which are still not evident.
We move to number 38. The woman says that elephant greet with another elephant with very enthusiastically. They scream and touch each other. They also use the greeting rumble and start with sound in 18 hertz, increase to 25 hertz and back again into 18 hertz. So we know that elephant greet begins and ends at the same pitch. So the answer is C. Then, number 39. We heard that when elephants make a contact call immediately after that, they will rotate their head to listening and to response. So, the answer is D, because we know that contact call is usually accompanied by a nod of the head. And number 40. We heard from the woman that when elephants want to summons to move on, one of them will move to the edge of the group, typically lift one leg and flap the ears, and they start to move on. So from this, we know that number 40, the answer is B. Summons to move on is usually accompanied by a leg movement. So that's all from our group, and thank you for your attention, and
wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.